And another verse also in Surah Al-Ra'd, and we find it in Surah Al-Baqarah as well, where Allah warns us.
وَالَّذِينَ يَنْقُضُونَ عَهْدَ اللَّهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مِيثَاقِهِ وَيَقْطَعُونَ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ أَنْ يُوصَلَ وَيَقْطَعُونَ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ أَنْ يُوصَلَ وَيُفْسِدُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ اللَّعْنَةِ.
الله أكبر. Allah says, the cursed are those who break the relations that Allah has instructed them to maintain. The cursed are those who break the relations. Allah says in Surah Al-Baqarah, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. They are the losers. Allah says, I gave you your brother, I gave you your sister, I gave you your relatives, I gave you your parents, your children. Why do you just go and break the relation with the smallest of reasons? A lot of the times it's connected to money matters. It's connected to sometimes perhaps you got married, they got married, maybe the spouses didn't get along, so they divide the brothers or sisters themselves. Why? That is not the way a mu'min should operate. Allah says, those are the losers. Imagine being called a loser. We would not like that. So the encouragement from this pulpit today is, let's go out of our way to maintain our family ties. Let's message our brothers and sisters to tell them how much we love them. Let's message them to say how much we care for them. Let's call them. Let's invite them over once in a while. Wallahi, ask those who live a singular life with no relatives or those who are in distant lands, they can never ever get together. They will tell you that, you know what, I feel lonely sometimes. They will be so happy when they see another family with so many relatives, and they will in their heart feel, I wish I was a part of this.